So, good afternoon to all of you. Okay, and I believe you are just starting your journey in the MBA school. All right, good. So, all excited? Do you know why you are here? You also understand and appreciate as to how you were handpicked to join this esteemed organized college. Okay, all right. Okay, so I do not have a presentation per se, but I would like to start with a proper interaction between you and me. Should you have any question, and from there I will build on to talk about what the world entails when you get into a course like this and what are the expectations. Okay, so that's the primary objective I have come with. If there is anything else I can help you to understand as to where are you heading yourself, and then I will be really glad. So open up questions. Anything. And talk whatever comes into your mind. Don't even think that whether it is right or wrong. The moment you get into that confusion, you would not talk.
Good afternoon, ma'am. I'm Deeksha Gakwa from Madhya Pradesh, Singrauli. Ma'am, I just like to ask that which would be the best field to explore ourselves? As from starting, we have been through multiple subjects. We have taught multiple subjects from our parents, from our being like engineering is good, medical is good. If you're not getting job, go for PGDM, go for MBA, you're going to get a job. But what from my personal point of view, exploring myself would be like, I like cooking, I am good at cooking, so I want to go in that field. But my parents and my family neighbor would say like, no, that field is not good for the women to pursue a career. You need a settled life, a settled family. So what that settlement means, and what how to start the career in a particular field, so that I can go to convince my parents also, and my means be satisfied in myself also, like, yes, I did the right thing and chosen the right path.
Yeah. And thank you very much for this question, and I'm sure most of you would be having it in your mind, okay? Because we generally land up choosing something which someone has told us is good for us. To some extent, I agree and I respect. You can be seated, please. So, to some extent, this is right, because their experience counts a lot, okay? And obviously, people around us kind of know us little better than people who are far away, okay? Because they are interacting with us every now and then. So, which is like our parents or our siblings or our close friends. But at the same time, the dilemma which has come very recently in the current generation is the fact that most of the time we do not express who we are. For example, if somebody is laughing, we start laughing. If somebody is going out somewhere, we tag along. Chal yaar, I don't have anything to do right now. Main bhi chalta hun. Okay? That is how we kind of tune ourselves to the social norms. But when it comes to career, no subject is lower rated than any other. Every subject has its own importance. We have seen the best of the chefs of the world, Vikas Khanna's, okay? We have seen Ranveer's and their Baraj's. So there are so many people out there, but what they have done, they have not let their passion go. Okay? The question comes, can it be done just like that, or should we get skilled? Alright? Now, when you come to a college like this, you are actually learning the skills to manage all of that. College would never ever tell you that you do this or you do something else. That is up to you to decide whether you want to do engineering, whether you don't want to do medical, you want to do paramedical, you want to do defense, you want to do cookery, whatever, beautician, okay, anything. I'm sure you would have read about Vasundhara Nair, Nykaa's owner, okay? So what background she comes from? From nowhere, okay? But you know what happens? It is the passion passion which drives the person. So internally you have to figure out. People around you will help you groom that passion. So you come to the best of the colleges because they help you to groom yourself, okay? Be it your own restaurant, be it your own business, be it your home for that matter. Let's assume that someday someone in family says, okay, the lady of the house will not work. But if you have gone through this learning process, upskilling process, you would know even being at home, how can you contribute to the growth of your family in an appropriate manner. Okay, so that is where the education comes. Now what happens to the passion? Your passion should not be influenced what the other person is doing. How many of you have seen Three Idiots? All of you. Good. There was one dialogue. Khud fail hone pe rona nahi aata. But jab dusre ko marks acche milte hain, that's when we feel otherwise. Okay? Exactly that is called as the low feeling syndrome. And most of us suffer that. Most of us. And it is not that we are intentionally suffering, but the environment around us is like that. Okay, so let go of those barriers. Parents suggesting, fair enough. Okay, they are telling because they know that world. For example, when I was in my teens, I was deciding what to do. I was very, very clear that I will get married because I always saw those who were getting married in my family would get a lot of jewelry, lot of saris, and lot of attention. So that was there in my mind, and I felt that's the world. But my father kept insisting, because I was pursuing pure maths as my main subject, that I should go for engineering. He was from IIT. So he always thought that I would also pursue that way. And that time I was totally lost because the people who were influencing me were coming from different backgrounds. It was just so that when I got married and I start thinking, I need some money to spend. Because for everything my husband would say, we will spend, but just wait. We have to make some savings, okay? And I would say this restriction I was not aware of. Because when I saw everyone else enjoying wedding life, I just saw, fun all around. That is when I thought that I cannot drop my education. So I did my master's, I did my MPhil, I did my MPA. And while doing that, I came across a different set of people who were very, very career focused. Very, very career focused. So they would not talk about what career to pursue. But what they would talk about is, mujhko ye karna hai, toh mujhko karna hai. That's it. If I have to go to Delhi by road, I have to go by road. That's it. There's no if and buts. How would I convince my parents? That is my take. So exactly same thing comes when it comes to your career. Now, many a times, because parents are the previous generation, they might not be exposed to all of this. For example, now today most of the youngsters, at least my kids, they only swear to Apple products. But I do not get head and tail of it. I just cannot manage it. So that's the generation gap. But if I have to use it, I will have to seek their help. I have to learn from them. All right? The same is with your parents as well. They come from the previous generation. You have to tell them, give them the live examples of how this career, which you feel you have your heart in, will help you grow better. Okay? You have read story of Bill Gates. You have read story of Microsoft. Okay? You have read story of Mark Zuckerberg. Okay? So what happens there? I mean, obviously they were high flyers, but you never know. There could be someone among us who might get into the same intense passion and reach there in no time. Today, during Diwali, I was looking at the Facebook and I found that there were some highly recognized YouTubers. Now, this was something which I was never aware of. Okay, and then they are the influencers. So they are talking to public through YouTube and passing on the information as to what needs to be done, how you have to manage anxieties, stress, and some of the other subjects. So this was never a career. In no curriculum you would find that. But the passion that I want to be a socialite, I want to connect with people, can actually give you avenues, and nobody can dictate that. Okay? So it's not you. The generation in the previous years as well had the similar kind of dilemma when it came to deciding the career. But every time you have to actually go through this phase of teaching the previous generation as to what it is and convincing them, and driving yourself to the point where you are expecting yourself to be. Okay? So I know, I mean, if you go to interiors of India, Chhattisgarh, you go to interiors of Uttar Pradesh, you go to interiors of Maharashtra, you wouldn't find parents very open to any other subject. They simply say either it has to be science or it has to be arts. Okay, they cannot imagine a brilliant student pursuing law, for that matter. It's not considered to be a very flourishing career, but it is. And today, because of the social networking, we get to hear that so many of them have done so well in their life. Right? So look into yourself. People, those who are having an inclination for analytics, I mean the data drives them. They see only numbers and their brain works that way. They should go for something which is in that direction. People who have the flair to talk to anyone. I'm sure in your schools you would have had debate competition. Not everyone would have the confidence to come onto the stage and talk. Okay, there's always this feel that, oh no, I'm not really sure what the other people would think. Okay, not that the person cannot talk, but this is a natural thing which comes from an individual. So having known this aspect of an individual self, it is always better to keep checking yourself, what you like the most. I mean, I am seeing now many of my earlier students, because I have been teaching parallelly since the time I started working for Infosys. They have left corporate jobs and they have gone in this, what you call as techno beauty parlors, which use technology, okay, to pep up an individual and make him or her feel good when it comes to hair or skin or whatever. All right, so it's up to you, absolutely up to you. However, if you are very clear where you want to be and you know that you have the confidence that you can drive it yourself, trust me, nobody can stop you influencing, making other people understand and follow what you are trying to do. And we have done it in past. Humko two wheeler chahiye tha. We gave all the excuses, everything, and we got it from our parents, knowing that at that early age it could have been a life risking activity. Okay, but we know how to convince. The only problem is we wait for someone else to do it for us. So don't do that. When you are waiting for someone else to influence you or to take a decision on your behalf, that means till date you are not very sure where you want to go. So take a pause, decide. And these colleges, curriculums, schools, certification programs do not teach you what to do. They teach you how to do. They only teach you how to do. There is yet to be a college discovered in this world which will tell you what to do. Okay? So how is brilliantly being defined, smoothened, presented by the colleges to each one of you? But normally what happens is, if you score really well, you say, oh, my college was brilliant, my professors were brilliant. And when you do not, then you say, oh no, the school or the college did not provide me the right education. They can't. They just can't. They are telling you how once and for every time. It's just up to you as to how you take that how and then explore yourself further. Anything else? Does it answer your question? Okay. Good. Please be seated. All right. Anyone else? Okay.
So much I have
तो बच्चा यू नो व्हाट इट इज, एज आई टोल्ड यू, नोबडी कैन एक्चुअली टीच यू व्हाट टू टेल देम. ओके, यू नो देम बेटर. व्हेन इज द राइट टाइम, हाउ यू वांट टू टेल इज समथिंग वन कैन हेल्प यू विथ. ओके, सो शो देम द एग्जांपल्स, एज आई सेड, शो देम समथिंग विच गिव्स देम द कॉन्फिडेंस टू आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन, लोग क्या सोचेंगे. ओके, देर आर मेनी एग्जांपल्स, एंड इन टूडेज लाइफ इट इज मच मोर ट्रांसपेरेंट. आई मीन नो वन्स लाइफ इज हिडन बिहाइंड द लेयर्स. ओके, सो लाइफ इटसेल्फ विल गिव यू दोज इंसिडेंट्स विच यू कैन प्रेजेंट टू देम कि आई कैन एक्चुअली डू दैट. I have two kids. I'll share my life example. I have two kids, my son and the younger one is my daughter. So I was always under the impression, because every time she would say, "Main kuch nahi, main sirf doctor banungi. I want to do operation." Okay. So I, like a fool, started saving money, knowing that okay, medical education is very costly in India. So let me save. She did her 10th, and she got her scores. And I said, "Chalo, phir science mein admission lena hai." Without that, to kaise hoga? Let me think. So I said, "All right, I'll give you that time." Now, to her good luck, I was traveling outside India for a week. When I came back, and I said, "Okay, chalo, abhi admission karna hai." So she said, "Nee, admission ho gaya." I said, "Kya liya?" So she said, "Haan, le liya mere ko jo lena tha." But kya liya kya? I have already taken humanities. I mean, my whole dream got shattered there itself. So I tried convincing her, without realizing that she had better convincing skills. Okay, so she told me, "Acha, agar main nahi kar paungi, to the last option for Indian girl is to get married. Aap mujhe shaadi kar dena. I will not even ask you a question." So then I convinced my husband and I said, "Theek hai, abhi wo bol hi rahi hai na, 3 saal wait kar lete hai, 4 saal, how does it matter, and dekhte hai." So she did her 11th, she scored about 41%. So I was further half dead, okay, and I knew nothing is going to move in my life with this girl. But then I kept convincing that she has promised me that she'll get married. In 12th, she topped Gujarat board in humanities. She knew exactly, which I never realized. Okay, so I was behaving like a typical mother, going all over and talking to all my office colleagues as to how legal studies will give an avenue for anyone to grow. And she kept telling me, "Main shaadi karungi na, I promise you." So she knew that is the ultimate, because she heard me talking to my family. So she did her 12th, she got through her LLB, she completed her LLB, and before I could have realized, she is now doing her masters in US. So the problem is that I also come from the same parent genre. Okay, it's very difficult for any parent to imagine that how a career would flourish for his or her kid. Okay, but somebody should exactly know when and how to convince, and that is the person who's sitting inside you. Now, opposite to that was my son, 6 years elder to him, to my daughter. And for everything he would come to me, "Ab main ye kar lu, to ab main HR kar lu." So I said, no, don't do HR. Me is from HR, your dad is from HR, and I think the world stops somewhere. So there is a ceiling. Okay, so we thought, and we got him into sales even when he was doing his engineering. So we said, "You should move to sales." So after doing his engineering, he went into TFI, he did his sales, and trust me, first year he struggled. He struggled to survive in the market because he never had that flair. It was me who dictated the terms for him, just go and do sales. Okay, so he then thought that there is no other option to go back now that he have made the decision, or else he have to study all over again. Okay, so after having that, he just cleared his head and said that I will start learning the skills. Then he went back to his professors, who were kind enough, because no professor will hold himself back. They are always available to teach you at any point in time in the life. Okay, so he went back to them. He said, "Sir, now you tell me what I should do, because I have struggled. So probably I have not learned my lesson properly. And gradually he did. Now after 6-7 years, he is well set. Okay? So it's not so that your first hit would go right. It is not so that what you are thinking is your passion is correct. Until and unless you express it to someone. Like, if I make rangoli, you guys would say, haan, bahut achha, bahut achha. But I know it is hopeless. It is much better than scribbling on a piece of paper. Alright? But there are people who do it professionally. And they do it wonderfully well. Wonderfully well. Okay? So it's just that you have to have few set of people who can recognize in true sense whether this is something you are willing to do or you are wanting to do or you have your heart in. In the same manner, you will have to talk to your parents. You figure out whether you are much more closer to your father or you are much more closer to your mother. Okay? And then decide how you want to do that. Log kya kahenge? Log to any which ways kahenge. Abhi, you have come here from Madhya Pradesh, then also they'll make a hue and cry of it. Okay? Ladki ko akele bhej diya, new jagah pe, how will she manage? So, such kind of retarders in your progress will always be there. But we have to live with it, that this is the social culture of our country. So we can't stop that.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I'll try to explore more and get into it. Thank you, ma'am.
Sure. Good afternoon, ma'am. Myself, Pradeep Kumar Roy Chaudhary. I'm from Bilaspur, Chhattisgarh. I have done my graduation in Economics Honours. Right now, I'm thinking about marketing as a specialization and HR too. Because I think I'm a people person and I am having a good communication skills. But it's a bit difficult to choose either of them. So can you guide me, ma'am? Means
why would it be difficult for you to choose,
ma'am? Because I think I have scope in marketing, but I am more towards HR too. Like, it's a good subject, I'm exploring that too. So it's
okay.
Yeah,
so first of all, go back to the professor or the lecturer who is responsible to teach you HR, or the person who's responsible to teach you marketing. He's the best person who can tell you what the subject entails. First, you have to understand, okay, what the subject has. So for example, marketing. Marketing is more of a creativity. It is not number driven, okay? Number driven is sales. So if you want to do sales, then to some extent, yes. But if you want to do marketing, then it is about how to present this mic and get customers for it. Okay? Have you ever been to Marwadi shops? I mean,
Chhattisgarh
is full of Marwadi shops.
Yes, okay? Ma'am.
So if you see, they are not well-educated people, but they know exactly what to sell to whom. Okay? Aap achhe iron kapde pehen ke jaoge, to wo 5 rupaye ki jagah aapko 50 rupaye ki cheez batayega aur kahega how it is important for you to pick this up. Okay, so that is what marketing is. So it's not sales, alright? So if you are creative and your professor tells you that in marketing subject, the curriculum gives you an understanding as how to enhance your creativity, how to express your creativity, then that is the subject you should go for. Okay, and on the other side, human resources is only talking and talking. There's nothing else. I've spent not 23 years, now it's like 29 years. So from last 29 years, it's how do we get closer to people is just by talking. Oh, tumko dard hua? Then we start talking about that. Okay. Oh, you got married? Then we start talking about how fancy Indian weddings are. So we just use that opportunity to talk. Now, the process, policies, and all have just 15-20% in the role. There's nothing more. Okay? Most of the organizations will follow generic policies, generic processes, because the people have their limitations to be in one, what you call as the horse eye. Okay? So with those two caveats, HR doesn't give you much. Until and unless you become but that is only in the later stage. When you start your career in HR, you do not get that opportunity immediately. You get it after 6-7 years. In certain cases, yeah, it could be an year or two earlier. All right? So you talk to your professors. They will guide you whether you have that inclination. And then you have to understand whether the curriculum will help you grow and advance your how part, how you are going to do that.
Got it, ma'am. Thank you.
Yes.
Sheikh Wasim Ahmed from Hyderabad.
You are?
I'm Sheikh Wasim Ahmed from Hyderabad.
Okay, from Hyderabad.
Yes,
okay.
Ma'am. Ma'am, how would you suggest a person disciplines themselves in the initial stages? Like right now, I know I want to do an internship and start my career, but then again, I'll be very picky and also have this anxiousness that I don't want this thing to end up my entire career and keep myself in a flaky position to just jump ship as I think that this is a better opportunity, that is a better opportunity. So how does a person settle themselves to, you know, row their boat one time at a time?
So you already have the answer. You should know how to row your boat. Okay? Have you seen a relay race? Okay? You have seen in relay there are 4 or 5 people to complete the whole race. Okay? Not everyone run with the same speed. Okay, why? Please be seated. Why? Why people do not run with the same speed? Bingo. Every individual has a different potential, different strength, different endurance. All right? So, the person who ensures that there is a success to that relay race is your coach, who understands where to place whom. Okay? And the coach places you, the race starts, and then the last person picks up the difference and completes it. Alright? Exactly the same thing is with you. So when you look around, the relay has already started. And you see, oh my God, this person is doing really well. He started making money. He bought a car to himself. Okay. He got a promotion. But you are not realizing that at some point in time, he might slow down. And why I am saying this so confidently, if that would not have been the case, then those who have topped class 10 should have topped class 12, should have topped all other entrance tests, exams, whatever they have done, okay? And they would have been the only ones leading the world. But it's not so, okay? You have 1,000 students coming out of IITs, not all of them have become CEOs. And that's the life example. So look around, feel good about it, that yes, this person has started getting benefits of the subject he has chosen, but probably you have a different taste altogether. You have a different taste. You'll have to give yourself some time. If you become very jittery, very, very anxious, then trust me, you will lose the race. You will definitely lose the race. Okay? So, basis your own, again, it comes to the passion, your energy, your inclination to do the thing. You have done it. Ek aur life example deti hu. You all have written 10th? सबने 10th जैसे ही स्टार्ट हुआ था वैसे ही पढ़ाई शुरू किया था. ओके, कितनों ने लास्ट के 2 महीने पढ़ा था? Here you go. क्यों? कुछ तो बच्चे होंगे ना, फर्स्ट डे से नोट्स, टाइम टेबल है ना, टीचर्स के पीछे कॉपी लेके, इट्स डन, प्लीज चेक, इजंट इट और नॉट? In the unit test or in the quarterly test, they would have scored much, much higher than anyone else. Did it or not? Okay. Why? Why you still did not get influenced? Because you knew that last 2 months are my life. I can focus only when there is a firefighting stage. If it is a very planned activity, many people doesn't get kick, as what I get to hear from my kids. Okay? Wo kick nahi mil raha. you when that kick you should be getting. There are many students. For example, we are four brothers sisters. I'm the elder one. My brother was very methodical. Time table lag jayega, trigonometry ke pure formulas lag jayenge, algebra ke pure formulas lag jayenge. I mean, about this table. And he would say that this is how I would remember. So I said, he always gets more attention from my mother. Let me also try. And I tried. I wrote it in a very nice handwriting. I still have those pages with me. But I never looked at it forever in my life. Okay? Because that was not me. I tried behaving like someone else. So it never worked for me. What worked for me was pre-board ke exam that I failed. Up to, there's only one way. That dad will ask me to get out of the house. So that fear gave me that kick to study. So in the same manner, there are many, many people, okay, who would have different ways of managing themselves. And it is all around you. So look at the life, look at people around you and learn from them. Don't just go what someone else is saying. Kitne log hote hain train station pe ya flight ke liye they follow that 2 hours. 2 ghante pehle chale jana hai. Okay, nahi, we wait till the last minute. Kya hai, 45 minutes mein to check-in ho jata hai. Okay, because that is how we are. But there are a few people who probably would reach 3 hours before scheduled time. That is how they are. So when you are deciding a career for yourself, okay, do not decide basis what others are doing. They may have a very different inclinations. Okay, go back to your personal families and you would see if you are a couple of siblings, each one of you have different taste. Very different taste, food taste, intelligence levels, okay, smartness, accuracy in doing things. It's different. While all of you have been grown up in the same family, given same values, same beliefs, yet, because that is somewhere inside us. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. So look at them, enjoy what they are doing. But if you try to imitate what they are doing, then probably you will end up not being very happy in life. Not very happy in life. Yes.
Good afternoon, ma'am. This is Nidhi Jaiswal from Kolkata. I have done in BA English Honours and I'm here.
You have done what?
BA English Honours.
Yes, ma'am.
So, ma'am, I have a query. Like, I have seen most of the people get a certified degree, job, salary, everything. But when people become CEO, managers, they lack something which is called humanity. That post changes people. And we have realized when we start from this career, we have seen. So, what would you suggest us to maintain connected through this, like, on the ground and understand what we are doing? Because when we reach at the peak, we lost the sense of humanity. So we need a connection for that, but to be a human being.
Yeah, you are right. So this is a very valid observation that when people go up at the pyramid, okay, typically they lose the connect. Okay? And it is a very natural science. You go higher up the crowd, can't see the ground. Isn't it or not? So with the same philosophical thinking, the world works that way. Now what we have to learn the good things from them. That how they are presenting themselves, yet not upsetting the crowd or the team which they are managing. This typically happens. For example, when probably you guys were little toddlers, little kids, your dad would have invested a lot of time with you. Okay? But when you were grown up and he sees that you are not much, he should be contributing in your life, he maintained the business. Okay? He started focusing in earning the bread for the family. And getting all the needs together for your next phase of life. Yeah? So that disconnect happens. And this usually happens when the confidence anyone. But it's not so they are disliking you. It's just that they want to make sure that everyone should feel similar when they are around. So people should not sense that they are biased or they have preferences for someone or they like or dislike something. It's just that. So they are not inhuman. I mean, they are not hardcore. What's the right word? Hitler kind of mindset. They don't have that. Okay, but the only thing is that they are wanting to give a very cold connect to the individuals so that they are not misread. So they are protecting their own image. They are not creating any kind of negative representation. Okay? Yeah. So you should do whatever you feel is good. And that is how it should be. Okay. All right. Yeah, please be seated. Anything else? Now that I have been shown an orange shirt saying 15 minutes. Anything else you want to ask? So, yes.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Khushi this side from Uttarakhand. I'm a BBA graduate. Ma'am, I am looking forward to start my career in HR domain. So I would like to ask you, would you like to share your experience that always work in corporate world, that the skills and the qualities that we have to develop to be a good HR manager in future? Thank you.
So first thing, whether it is HR or anything, when you enter, we take a step back. When, so you would have given your group discussion, you would have been interviewed, okay, while taking this college. So what was within you when you came for the interview, for the discussion? How did you present yourself? कैसे आए थे ऐसे विद नो यू केम विद द कॉन्फिडेंस दैट आई हैव टू डू दिस दैट इज द प्राइमरी कोर स्किल रिक्वायर्ड बाय एवरी इंडिविजुअल बिफोर ही और शी गेट्स इनटू द कॉर्पोरेट वर्ल्ड व्हाई आई वुड एम्फसाइज दैट इट इज वेरी मच रिक्वायर्ड नॉन निगोशिएबल इन कॉर्पोरेट वर्ल्ड इज बिकॉज देर आर मेनी पीपल अराउंड यू देर ओके You are not very sure how they are perceiving you. You do not have enough time to convince everyone and give a clarity as to why you did something the way you did. So confidence is the only tool you enter a corporate world with. That's first. Now when you are pursuing HR, you have decided that you want to pursue HR. As I said, HR is more about connecting with people. Okay? But at the same time, while you are connecting with people, you also have to see the larger picture of the company. Is company wanting to do these things? You might be very close to people. People will come to you, okay, 10 days of leave is less. I need 12 days. I'm getting married. You should give me unpaid leave for another 1 month because I want to spend time, enjoy this moment of my life. All of that is right. But does the organization have the appetite to take that much? Okay? Now, I'm sure many of you would have your parents or some family member in the government jobs. Okay? Because in government jobs, there is nothing called discipline as such around this particular piece. Okay? That's why people prefer going there since it becomes a leisure life. It's a relaxed life, okay? But there is no growth. Somebody who enters at one particular position, until and unless he really struggles and make good relationship with the top players, he doesn't move a step ahead in the whole of his career. But in the corporate world, it is not so. So when you are confident and you know how to manage the top players, okay? Which means you do not have to say yes to a yes. You do not have to say no to a no. What you need to do is you have to understand their part of story as well, as to what they are trying to say. And then figure out a balanced solution. So it's just not for the HR, while it is primary for HR, but the same thing is applicable to all other fields. Because when you enter the corporate world, you will have to work with someone. You cannot say that, okay, I'm coming from Indus, so I know it all, and I will be the one who will lead. The seniors probably from Indus would not allow you to do that. Okay, that's the human funda. Very, very logical. So, confidence is the first step, and the confidence comes when you know your subject. And when would you know your subject? Only when you really want to know that. How many of us know history? Many of us just studied history because we wanted to score some marks to pass the paper. Okay? But nobody remembers. The same is, how many of us would remember the chemistry organic formulas? Nein, we did that just because in 10th it was required. After that we never looked at it. Okay? So if you are passionate about a particular subject and you pursue that as a career, 50% of your confidence is already in place then. Because you know it. How you want to handle it. Okay? The rest 50% is partly developed in your ecologists, like this one, where they tell you how to present yourself. And the last 25% of that 50% is developed self. Because you know yourself very well. There are people who would present themselves with great communication. There would be people who probably would not have a good verbal communication, but they have excellent written communication. Okay? There will be people who might not have written and verbal, but they have expressions which they use to their benefits. Alright? So that is how you would survive in HR. Typically, the general sense in HR is that HR is a side job. Okay? And everyone feels they know it all. Everyone feels, marketing will feel, I know HR. Okay? Sales will feel, we know HR. Product development would know, we know it. Computer science engineers are the boss. They feel that, okay, they know it all, but it is not so. Knowing is different, driving is different. Okay? So when I look at someone driving a four-wheeler, automatic four-wheeler, I say, ye to kya hai? Ko aata hai, I can drive. But when you get onto the steering, then you realize, no, it's not that easy. You probably need some practice. Okay? In the same manner, people will come and they bully indirectly to pull the confidence down. Because they are more worried about their confidence. This is typical human psychology. Nothing new. It happens even in our schools and college days. Where someone comes and says, tu kya padh raha hai, mera pura ho gaya taiyar. And we get started anxious. Yaar, isne padh liya, mera to kya hoga. Okay? So with that feeling, the world doesn't change. Be in corporate, be anywhere. So you have to make sure that you protect your confidence, you know your subject, you know what you are doing, how you are doing, and you respect your subject. कभी ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए अरे यार क्यों आई टू एचआर ओके आई गॉट इन्फ्लुएंस बाय मालिनी साथी आई गॉट इन्फ्लुएंस बाय माय पेरेंट्स एंड आई डिसाइडेड दैट आई शुड परस्यू नाउ आई एम रिपेंटिंग टाइम वुड नॉट कम बैक ओके सो व्हाटएवर यू डू थिंक लॉजिकली फील इन योर हार्ट एंड देन साइन अप फॉर इट और एल्स डोंट डू Take a break, take a pause. It's absolutely fine. In today's time, nobody is questioning. There are people, how many people, especially in Infosys during those days, people would work for about 7-8 years and then take a break to go to a B school. Because they would see that, okay, B school probably will help them equip how part little better. So that is what is required from each one of us. So don't think a lot. Think only for yourself. Where do you, what are the things you like and where does it sit in your body. If it is sitting in the heart, if somebody wakes you up at 12 o'clock and says, hey, you know what, I need you to understand the theory of organization development, and you are up in your dreams, you can talk about it. That is what your career is all about. Okay? But if before the exams you know that the sheet is out and you are wondering, yaar, padna padega, then that is not the subject meant for you. These are the indicators. Okay? How many people are passionate about food? So, good. So there are many who like vegetarian, non-vegetarian. What food you like? Vegetarian. So when he sees non-vegetarian, probably it's not so that he cannot, but he would leave it aside. That this is not me. I can't. But the moment he sees vegetarian and something which is very close to his taste, he will jump on it, irrespective of whether cooked by mother, father, hotel, friend. Okay? So we need to understand ourselves first, and it is high time. The world is changing. We have seen it in last 18, 20 months. Okay? You are the ones who are going to take the world to the next level. And there is lot of money which is sitting on your shoulder. When I say lot of money, corporates are depending only on you. They need people. Okay? But they need people who can drive themselves. They don't need work horses who needs to be driven. Mara, do block chala. Phir mara, phir do block chala. Aise they don't need. It's high time. Okay? So get yourself energized every day. If you're getting up for the class, get up with the confidence that today is my day and I'll make it. And you will reach where you want. But the moment you say, hey, yaar, the saad mujhe bula le gaye. Okay? Then either you miss that class, say sorry to your professor, sit back in your room, or you decide, why am I feeling so low about it? Okay? It's no compulsion. Don't do it for others. Do it for yourself. Just for yourself. And then you will be good. I mean, you guys are very smart. At least you have technology to yourself. You have so many people. You go to LinkedIn, you send the request to people, and then they start giving you a lot of their experiences, what should be done and what should not be done. A lot of guidance now. Through all these mediums. During our times, there wasn't any. So, I'm sure that you guys would fare well. Anything else I can help you with? Any other question? Yeah.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Deeksha Gaikwad this side from Singrauli, Madhya Pradesh. Ma'am, just a last question. As you have mentioned that you have started your master's and career after getting married. So how you have managed your professional and personal life together? Like how you have managed your family and job, everything?
Because I wanted to do it. It is as simple as that. If I want to do something, I do. We all do. When we want to go to our friend's place and we know there is an exam which you have to do well, you study and then you go, or you make sure that you first enjoy the day with your friend and come back and then study. So there is no rocket science, there is no formula for it. It is just that
ma'am. I'll take care of that. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for this wonderful and insightful session. It was full of knowledge and liveliness. I hope the students have enjoyed this session to the core and learned a lot from this session. Best wishes to your future endeavors, ma'am, with the hope of meeting you again. And thank you, Jai sir, faculty members and the students for attending this session.